डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई मिस्टर विशाल शाह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कृष्णा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी कराड, वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस सेशन ऑन द फार्मास्यूटिकल एनालिसिस। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रिपरेशन एंड स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन ऑफ सम स्टैंडर्ड सॉल्यूशंस। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑल्सो वी हैव कवर्ड द प्रिपरेशन एंड स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन ऑफ फ्यू सॉल्यूशंस लाइक हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड, नाइट्रिक एसिड, सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड एक्सेट्रा, परक्लोरिक एसिड ऑल्सो। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कवर रिमेनिंग थ्री डिफरेंट स्टैंडर्ड सॉल्यूशंस लाइक पोटेशियम परमैंगनेट, सिरिक अमोनियम सल्फेट, सोडियम थायोसल्फेट एक्सेट्रा। इफ यू हैव नॉट वॉच्ड माई प्रीवियस वीडियो रिलेटेड टू द फार्मास्यूटिकल एनालिसिस, यू कैन वॉच माई प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑल्सो। इफ यू आर कमिंग फर्स्ट टाइम टू दिस माई यूट्यूब चैनल, please subscribe to my YouTube channel to get more videos related to the pharmaceutical analysis. Now let's begin with our today's session. Before starting our today's session, we will see what are the learning outcomes of this session, means what you should understand after watching this particular video. So after this session, students will be able to explain how to prepare and standardize different standard solutions. So as I said, in this video, we are going to cover three different standard solutions like ceric ammonium sulfate, then potassium permanganate, as well as the sodium thiosulfate. So first, we will begin with the potassium permanganate. Now, here we are going to carry out the preparation of 0.02 molar potassium permanganate solution. And just I will tell you how to carry out the standardization of this potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate is one of the most important titrant that is used for the purpose in the oxidation reduction type of the reaction, where potassium permanganate is acting as an oxidizing agent. So many titrations are there where this particular, this particular potassium permanganate is used to carry out the standardization or determination of different reducing agents. So first, we will see what is the molecular formula of potassium permanganate, that is the KMnO4. Molecular weight of potassium permanganate is 158.03. Then how to carry out the preparation of potassium permanganate: dissolve 3.2 gram of potassium permanganate in 1000 ml of water. We have to heat it on a water bath for 1 hour, allow to stand for 2 days, and filter through the glass wool or the filter paper. So in this way, we have to carry out the preparation of the potassium permanganate. Why there is need to stand the solution for 2 days? Because whatever the potassium permanganate there, it is necessary to dissolve that particular potassium permanganate. So whatever the impurities are there, that must be removed. And for that purpose, potassium permanganate needs to be kept for 2 days. So that solution will be prepared accordingly. So this is about the preparation of the potassium permanganate. Now store the solution in a dark place and protect it from light. Otherwise, whatever the potassium permanganate is there, it might get the reduced, and due to which it is necessary to protect that particular solution from the light. Then we will see how we are going to carry out the standardization. As I said in previous videos also, why there is need to carry out the standardization. First of all, potassium permanganate is a secondary standard. So when we are going to prepare the solution of the secondary standard, exact concentration of that particular solution, that is the normality as well as the molarity, is not achieved, and it is necessary to theoretical normality or molarity, I want to say. Means here there is need to carry out the determination of the exact strength of that particular solution, and for that purpose it is necessary to carry out the standardization. Now here there are several ways are there by which potassium permanganate can be standardized. Here we will be looking for the standardization by using the sodium oxalate or the oxalic acid. So what is the procedure for that? Weigh accurately 0.1 gram of dry sodium oxalate, dissolve in 80 ml of distilled water, add 5 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid continuously to it. Cool the solution to 25 to 30 degrees Celsius and stir until oxalate has been dissolved. Then add 90 to 95% of required KMnO4 from the burette at the rate of about 25 to 30 ml per minute. while stirring slowly. Heat the solution to 55 to 60 degrees Celsius and complete the titration by adding KMnO4 drop wise until faint pink color persists for 30 seconds. So actually what happens when we are going to carry out the addition of KMnO4, at the near end point the pink color is developed, but that pink color is not permanent. So we have to check whether permanent pink color is produced for about 30 seconds. So when a pink color is produced, we have to heat that particular solution at about 50 to 60 degrees Celsius, and if this color disappears, then again we have to carry out the titration, that is, we have to carry out the addition of the KMnO4. And if after heating also the color is does not disappearing, then we have to stop that particular titration, we have to take that particular reading. So this is about the standardization. Then we will see what is the reaction involved in that particular titration. So here you can see sodium oxalate is first reacted with the H2SO4 to give a oxalic acid. As I said, here we are going to carry out the standardization either using sodium oxalate or the oxalic acid. So in first reaction, why there is need to carry out the addition of H2SO4? It leads into the conversion of sodium oxalate into the oxalic acid. So here you can see 5 moles of oxalic acid are reacted with 2 moles of potassium permanganate to give us a manganese sulfate. So this is about the reaction. So here what is important? 5 moles of oxalic acid are required to react with the 2 moles of KMnO4, that is the potassium permanganate. So that is important in the factor calculation. As I said, 2 moles of KMnO4 is equivalent to 5 moles of sodium oxalate. So here if we convert it into the liquid form, that is the 2000 ml of 1 molar KMnO4 is equal to 5 into molecular weight of sodium oxalate, that is the 133.98 gram. Now if we convert it into the 1 ml, means just we have to divide it this by 2000, and also we have to convert 1 mole into the 0.02. So by conversion, that is the dividing by first 2000, and again by dividing with the help of the conversion, that is the here by 20, we will get the molarity, that is the 0.02. So 1 ml of 0.02 molar KMnO4 is equivalent to 0.0067 gram of sodium oxalate. So this is the factor that is used for the purpose of the calculation. So this is about the preparation and standardization of the potassium permanganate. Next we will see the preparation and standardization of sodium thiosulfate. For this purpose, here we are going to use the 0.1 molar of the sodium thiosulfate. Molecular formula of sodium thiosulfate is Na(S2O3). Then molecular weight 158.11. Now preparation: dissolve 25 gram of sodium thiosulfate and 0.2 gram of sodium carbonate in a carbon dioxide free water. Now in previous video also I have told you how to prepare carbon dioxide free water. Just we have to take our required quantity of the water and we have to boil that particular solution. Due to the boiling, whatever the dissolved form of the carbon dioxide is there, it will be escaped into environment and our water becomes carbon dioxide free. Again we have to cool that solution and we have to dilute it to the 1000 ml with the water, that is the same solvent. So in this way sodium thiosulfate is prepared. Then standardization. Now for that purpose the procedure is dissolve 0.2 gram of potassium bromate, weighed accurately in sufficient water to produce the 250 ml. To 50 ml of this solution we have to carry out the addition of 2 gram of potassium iodide. Now why potassium iodide? Here the whatever the potassium bromate that is to be added, it is acting as a primary standard, and that potassium bromate will react with the potassium iodide to release the iodine. Where potassium iodide is acting as a reducing agent, potassium bromate is acting as a oxidizing agent. So potassium iodide when react with the potassium bromate, it leads into the formation of iodine, and the iodine that is formed, that is titrated with the sodium thiosulfate. This type of titration is known as the iodometry. Actually iodine titration, when we are going to see the iodine titrations in detail we are going to discuss, but just for reference you understand there are two different types of iodine titrations. One is the iodometry and other one is the iodimetry. Here we are not using directly iodine solution, but we are preparing the iodine solution. That's why it is known as the iodometry. And in iodimetry, we are going to use the standard solution of the iodine. Okay. So again, we have to add the 2 molar hydrochloric acid and we have to titrate it with the sodium thiosulfate solution using star solution as an indicator, which must be added towards the end of titration as an indicator until blue color is discharged. Here I2 forms, that is the liberated iodine forms a blue colored complex with the starch, and when iodine is not present at that time, this blue color will be disappeared. The iodine that will be formed, it will be formed equivalent to the that particular potassium bromate, that is the amount of potassium bromate that is to be consumed. So this is about the standardization procedure that is used for the sodium thiosulfate solution. Again, we have to carry out the re-standardization of the solution frequently as we keep the standing of that particular solution. Now we will see what is the reaction. Here, as I said, potassium bromate, which is acting as an oxidizing agent, will react with the 1 mole of hydroiodic acid, that is the potassium iodide, which leads into the formation of this particular potassium bromide. Now further, this bromate in presence of the liberated iodine will react with the potassium iodide, that is the iodide ions that are generated from this Hi, which leads into the formation of the iodine. 3 moles of iodine that are formed, and these moles are finally titrated against the sodium thiosulfate, which leads into the formation of sodium tetrathionate. Then factor calculation. Here you can see in this reaction, 3 moles of sodium thiosulfate into 2, that is the 6 moles of sodium thiosulfate are required, or they are reacting with the 3 moles of iodine, that is equivalent to 1 mole of potassium bromate. So 6 moles of sodium thiosulfate is equivalent to 1 mole of potassium bromate. Then if we convert it into the 6000 ml of 1 molar sodium thiosulfate is equivalent to 167 gram of potassium bromate. So 1 ml of 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate is equivalent to 0.002783 gram of potassium bromate. So this is about the preparation and standardization of sodium thiosulfate. Next solution we are going to discuss is ceric ammonium sulfate. Molecular formula: NH4 twice, selenium SO4 twice H2O. Molecular weight 632.56. Now how to carry out the preparation? Dissolve 65 gram of ceric ammonium sulfate with the aid of gentle heating in a mixture of 30 ml of sulfuric acid and 500 ml of water. Cool, filter the solution if turbid and dilute to 1000 ml of water. So in this way, preparation of the ceric ammonium sulfate is carried out. Then standardization. Weigh accurately about 0.2 gram of arsenic trioxide, which is acting as a primary standard, previously dried at 105 degree Celsius for 1 hour and transferred to a 500 ml of conical flask. Then wash the inner walls of the flask with 25 ml of 8% weight by volume solution of sodium hydroxide, swirl to dissolve and add 100 ml of water. Add 30 ml of dilute sulfuric acid, then 0.15 ml of osmic acid solution and 0.1 ml of ferroin sulfate solution as an indicator. Slowly titrate with the ceric ammonium sulfate solution until the pink color is changed to a very pale blue color, adding the titration slowly towards the end point. Then this is reaction. Two reactions are occurring, that is the oxidation reaction and a reduction reaction, where 4 moles of selenium are equivalent to 1 mole of arsenic trioxide. So 4 moles of ceric ammonium sulfate is equal to 1 mole of arsenic trioxide. So again, the final factor, 1 ml of 0.1 molar ceric ammonium sulfate is equivalent to 0.004946 gram of arsenic trioxide. So this is about the preparation and standardization of the ceric ammonium sulfate. Now here you are having some exercise. You have to go to this particular website, you have to copy this particular link and paste, and you have to provide the answer for